We'll look at a diagram of enthalpy versus weight percent. This is for sulfuric acid and water. And the enthalpy is per kilogram of the solution. And our objective is to use this diagram to determine what would be the adiabatic temperature of mixing. So this is an exothermic process. The enthalpy of the mixture, you can see, is significantly lower than the enthalpy of the pure components. So it's non-ideal. If it were ideal, the enthalpy would just be the mass fraction of component 1 times the enthalpy per kilogram of component 1 plus the mass fraction of component 2, enthalpy 2. Enthalpy 2 is here, enthalpy 1 is here, and we could rearrange this by writing it just in terms of the mass fraction of component 1. And you can see this says for an ideal solution, we just expect a straight line. So, for example, if we were to start at 38 degrees, here's pure component 2, here's pure component 1. What we would expect then is for any mixture, the enthalpy is somewhere along this line. So if we made a 50-50 mixture, the enthalpy of the mixture would be here. If it's adiabatic then, we also then expect that the enthalpy of the mixture is going to be equal to the enthalpy of the starting components. And the difference is now this is not at the same temperature. So this is going to be at a higher temperature than the enthalpies of our starting materials. So let's look at this diagram and do this problem where we're going to mix pure sulfuric acid and pure water. And our objective is to obtain a 30% solution. And if the water and the sulfuric acid are both at 15 degrees, then the question is, what is the temperature of the final solution? And so this means 15 degrees. This is our starting value for the water enthalpy. And 15 degrees here, starting value for sulfuric acid. So then all we have to do is say the enthalpy of the mixture has to be along this line because it's adiabatic. So the enthalpy has to be the sum of our starting enthalpies. And then if we determine where 30% is, which is right around here, so this would be a 30%, then we could just read the temperature off this diagram that it's somewhere between 60 and 82. We had to make an approximation. It's about 70 degrees C. So 70 degrees C, that's the adiabatic temperature when we mix pure material starting at 15 degrees C. So the other question we could ask is, suppose we wanted to mix them isothermally, how much heat would we need to remove from the mixture per kilogram of mixture? And so this means our final enthalpy, if we mix them adiabatically, we can read about 380 kilojoules per kilogram of mixture. If we wanted it to be isothermal, so we want the final temperature to be 15 degrees, we have 30%, 15 degrees is about here, which is an enthalpy of about 200. This is what we desire to make it isothermal. This is what we would end up with if we did the adiabatically. So that means we need to remove 180 kilojoules. So we'll do one more problem. And this is one you might first try on your own. But we want to mix 10%, that's weight percent, sulfuric acid, that's at 15 degrees, with a mixture of 80% sulfuric acid, that's at 38 degrees. And the question is, what's the final temperature? So, of course, there's one more piece of information we need, and that's what is our final composition? What we're going to do is mix 1.5 kilograms of the 10% sulfuric acid and 1 kilogram of the 80%. So we need to determine what's the composition of the mixture. So the simplest way is to say, well, we're going to end up with 2.5 kilograms. The 10% is going to provide 1.5 multiplied by 0.1, so 0.15 kilograms sulfuric acid. And the 80% is 1, so that means we have 0.95 kilograms of sulfuric acid. And our mixture is a total of 2.5 kilograms. So this is 0.38 kilograms of sulfuric acid per kilogram of mixture, or we're at 38% on our diagram. So to determine the temperature now, we can draw a straight line between our starting points, between this 10% and this 80% at different temperatures. We're going to be at 38% for our mixture, so the point has to be on this line. So right here is our mixture, and we can then read off the diagram that this is somewhere between 38 and 60, maybe a little more than halfway, so maybe 52 degrees C. That's certainly an approximation, but this would be the adiabatic temperature.